Welcome back to the Imaginary Gallery. It's TJ, your host. Tonight's discussion is involving a little test you can perform on potential cluster bead creature that you may have become involved with. In this video, what I'll be doing, first of all, advising you of this little test you can perform, and then I'll give you a few examples of the types of answers you may receive when asking the question. The purpose of this test is basically to see if your potential creature is able to do something that we call self-reflect. We know these creatures are incapable of such a thing, so what better way than to test them for it? The way you may do this: choose an event that happened that was inconsistent with something the creature said. Ask them the simple question. Say, whatever it happened, and it's all over with, and it's not a good thing that happened. You're trying to have a discussion like adults do. Ask the question. So tell me, what was going through your head when you made the decision to do what you did, whatever it may be? I'll repeat. Tell me what was going through your head at the time that you made the decision to do whatever it is you had done. What this does is reveal if A, the person is being honest with you, B, the person is a person to begin with, C, will clear up you're dealing with a con artist. It'll be quite obvious. We'll start with an example of a real person's testimony of their thought process, such as, there's someone you know who hates country music. Cannot stand it, and makes it a point to say it all the time, and let's say you happen to drive by a country music festival, and you see this very person there, smiling, surrounded by a bunch of little kids, looking a little awkward. That's the basis of this example. You question the person later, and say, hey, I saw you at that country fest. You look kind of weird. I know you don't like country, you say, but why don't you tell me what thought process brought you to be in that situation? Well, the healthy example would be something on the order of,
I know I can't stand country music. You know I can't stand it. I hate it. My little niece wanted to see me. It was her birthday. The last 2 times for her birthday, I got busy and couldn't see her. This time, it just so turned out that I was free, so I thought I'd make it up to her. I asked her where she wanted to go, and she said the country music fest. If she was just a normal friend or buddy of mine, and they said they wanted to go to that country music fest, well, I would have just said, oh, country ain't my thing, sorry, because I can't stand that twangy sound. But because I hadn't seen her, my mind was thinking
that this poor girl,
she really misses me. She's going to grow up without ever knowing me. What can I do to make this up to her? Oh, I'm free. Oh, I'll ask her if she wants to go somewhere, and she said the country music fest. Typically, I would say no, but I'm thinking, well, this is my only chance to see her, so who am I to be too good for that? I'll go. She was happy, and I pretended like I was happy, which I was happy being with her, and it was a successful visit.
That's the example of a healthy situation. The second part of this, the example that would indicate potential trouble, which I won't necessarily relate it to that particular story. That was just to illustrate what it looks like. Say it's your partner that you're concerned may be one of these cluster B creatures that you made the mistake of sticking around with after it swore its love and devotion to you, but then you found out it ran off with the babysitter, for example. Because many of us that do have the full spectrum of emotions may look at such a situation as, this person did something bad and wrong. Should I just abandon them? No, maybe it was a mistake. And of course, they'll read into this if they're a creature, and they may say, oh, I made a mistake. With your potential toxic creature, after it's done something that would normally be inexcusable to you, this is when you'd ask that question for the best result. Remember, it love-bombed you at the beginning and told you how it was devoted to you and no one else even caught their eye, and all of a sudden you went out of town unexpectedly that one weekend and always were suspicious that he had a thing for that babysitter because her breath were just a little bigger than yours, and he's a breast man. But every time you'd ask him,
are you looking at her? I think you like her.
He would say something like,
I didn't even pay attention to her. She's not my type. Honey, you are.
Even though you know he likes the larger cup size, you can't get these people to break character. So even if you were to say something like, I see every time she's here, you're always looking at her chest area. Come on, If you try any of that,
You're paranoid, honey. You need to accept the fact that I love you and no one...
They'll say that kind of crap. So that's where this comes in. Let's just say it does happen. That you went out of town, came back, you were suspicious because you knew the babysitter was going to be coming around, and you were worried that your little potential perfect person is running off with that blonde babysitter. When you're away, you try to call on, like, Friday night, which typically you'd expect an answer, but there is no answer. You also happen to know that that babysitter is going to be in town that very night. So your brain goes crazy thinking, oh no, this person might fall for that babysitter. Prior to this day, it had said,
oh honey, you have nothing to worry about. I'm just going to rest and relax. I'm not going to go anywhere.
Or something like that, which is designed to make you feel comfortable. Okay, let's just say that several weeks later, months later, somebody reveals,
I saw your guy that one weekend that you were gone. I think you were out of town. Yeah, he was with that blonde teat chick. Yeah, they were laughing it up. I thought you'd broken up. I was going to go ask him, but I decided not to.
Then you hear this and you realize, because you're seeing the person daily acting as if everything's just fine, this piece of the storyline has never come into play, and as far as it's concerned, it doesn't exist. But now you've done the horrific thing of going behind its back to find out what it's up to. In many cases, you would just say, well, you know what, this is over, goodbye, and be gone. But unfortunately, these creatures have a way of digging their way in, so you end up sticking around longer than you should, usually because of the offsetting of realistic behaviors with their love-bombing crap. That's so over the top. If you don't know it's a game, you're going to think, oh, I really can't just abandon this person over this one thing. But the answer is, oh, yes, you can. We'll try to justify that maybe the person made a mistake, maybe I was too rough, or maybe I did something wrong, and you'll be questioning all this. It is a man, and then she is pretty, so maybe she tempted him, and he went with her. Oh, well, hopefully it wasn't any fun. And then he says this to you.
Oh, she was gross. Her breath stunk, and I just kept thinking of you.
They'll try to play it down, minimize it, which is designed to soothe you into sticking around longer so they can do it again. This is the type of situation you could dig into, and it might give an excuse. Typical would be, well, because you weren't here, I did this, or because you had said something some other time, I did this. Some unrealistic type excuse. And what typically will happen is they'll give you that ridiculous excuse. You'll sit and think about it, and you'll be replaying in your mind later when you're not around this creature. You'll be thinking, but wait a second. I had asked questions because of my concerns, and I was assured that that would never happen, and you're going through all that, but then you're realizing it did happen, so you're trying to bridge the gap between the false information and the real information, and that's when you could again say, tell me again, that weekend I went out of town, what was going through your head when you made that decision to run off with the babysitter? Another indication you're dealing with a creature here will be, they'll say,
oh, would you drop that subject? I told you, she wasn't any good, her breath stunk, and I only did it because of blah, 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 blah.
Very cold response. Very much different from the creature that was the love bomber in the beginning. But if you can get the person calmed down, try again and say, walk me through the steps. The point is, you were suspicious. You had to leave town. Your biggest fear was that he was going to run off with this chick. It assured you it wouldn't, but you still worried because there's something in the back of your head that just tells you something's not completely right with this person. You're assured later nothing happened, even though there was no answer when there normally would be, and all that. Then months later, you find out the truth. Well, that's a pretty dramatic situation. Well, these creatures are banking on that. What kind of friendly, loving person would want to deliberately set a person up in that situation so they would be traumatized? I'll tell you who or what kind. A cluster B creature. What you're looking for, if you try to get them again to say, I understand what happened, it happens over, but walk me through the process. They either won't do it, or they'll make it very generic, or they'll scream and say, I've told you this already, would you drop this? In their mind, they're entitled to have you. You know what they did, and you're still there. As far as they're concerned, well, you deserve whatever comes and do not need to say a word about it. If you don't hear a story like in the first example, such as, which I doubt you would hear if it's a creature, but the way it should sound if they're going to be honest would be,
well, I don't really love you, and you were going out of town, and I've been looking at that babysitter, and she's so hot, and I thought this is my chance to get her. I know she thought I was hot, too. I saw her looking at me. When you went out of town, I decided I'd try for her, and figured I'd just tell you I didn't do it, and that I'd threaten her and tell her not to tell you, and I was going to do this.
And that would be like a realistic story, but of course you would never hear anything like that from these creatures. You'd be more likely to hear,
well, because you had said this to me, well, I decided to go here and do that. It wasn't any fun. I wanted to be with you, and you keep bringing this up.
If you hear things like this, that's a pretty good indication you're dealing with a monster creature, and it's best to get lost. because they can't even walk you through a normal thought process. All they want to do is go back to their generic, fake, superficial excuses and say, I already told you why. And it's like, I'm not asking you why, I'm asking you to walk me through. What happened when you woke up that morning? Because often they'll try to say they didn't want to do it or something like that. But if you think about it in detail, you realize that you've got this person with you. They've made all those claims about you. So being with the babysitter should be the very last thing that ever happens. However, it does happen. You know that there had to be something like, oh, I kept thinking of her, how pretty she was, and I really wanted to be with her, and that would be something more realistic, but you're never going to hear that story. The generic story you hear is pretty much an indication that a real story like that, what I just said, would be the truth, but they're not going to tell you that. Why would that be? Well, because if you knew that, that may jeopardize your supply giving to this creature, because you know it for what it really is and would be repulsed and probably run the other way. Well, they can't have that. They're too selfish. They want you for whatever they're using you for. They don't want you to have that information. We don't need people like that that decide what we do and don't need to know about. Kind of like our mainstream media, which is dying a slow death. Good, because it's programmed and controlled, designed to influence us to think certain ways and to be divided, which is not the right answer. Try this little trick. You can do it at different times, too, just to get a feel for the person. It doesn't have to be about a controversial event. It could just be about something else that didn't make sense. You could have been a person who saw that boy at the country place and said, you're a liar. You were at a country festival. I knew you were lying. That's not productive if there's no reason to behave in that manner. And the situation with, like, example two, hell yes, ask those questions and look for a realistic. Because so many of these creatures will act as if they did what they did and they didn't want to and it was so miserable. You have to know that, like, wait a second, you had me. You knew I was away. You knew I'd be back. Even if she flirted with you and shook her teeth, you could have just thought, nice try, honey, but I'm happy with who I have, because that would go along with all the other script that goes with the love bombing and the idealization. But instead, it's a completely different plot twist, and you're looking to make sense of it, but they'll try to mess it all up for you. Hopefully you've gotten a clue out of this information. Sometimes you have to be thinking on your own completely, because you know as a human being that if this devoted person was going to break their word and run off with a babysitter, it would be a severely dramatic thing that would cause it to happen, because it's so out of character with who you think you're dealing with. But obviously it's not when you hear, oh, well, I just did it because of this and that. And keep in mind that people typically don't engage in such behaviors if they don't have any interest in doing so. It takes effort. It also takes organization, sneaking, setting things up, covering tracks, and all of that. You have to ask yourself when you're dealing with this creature claiming, oh, it had no fun doing it, oh, it would rather be with you and all that, and think, okay, what kind of person would actually wake up and make that decision to do whatever it did that ended up with it being alone with the babysitter? When you're hearing the answers, they don't fit, because that's not the behavior of a person who doesn't want to do such a thing. Their behavior would be more on the order of, she tried to flirt with me when you were gone. I told her, you witch, I would never touch you with a 10-foot pole. If that's true, then that would be a good response. But you can never be sure.
Hi, I am the Narcopath. This is my new lover. What are you doing, honey? What's your name? Be quiet!
Sorry about that. As you know, I am the Narcopath. I know you've missed me in my confessions. There supposedly says, DJ, Kelvin, you put your life back together after the damage that I caused. If I could cause such damage, then I guess I must be pretty special.
I know you had a lot of questions about my sister.
When we were together, you used to accuse me of colluding with her. No, not Russia, but my sister, Rahisha. You thought that I plotted things with her, and I told you, oh, that is crazy, there's no way, you're just wrong. Since I'm giving y'all confessions, yes, it's true. I come from a family of narcobats. That means the mother, the father, the sister, the brother. I used to work in tandem with my sister. She'd cover up for me. That one time when there was a discrepancy with a story I told you and something she told you that I told her to tell you, you figured it out that I had manipulated the situation because she kind of got the story wrong, which contradicted my story. So clearly, it's like those school shootings that have so many different storylines going on, and if you put them all down together, they can't all be true at once. You actually accused me of coaching her what to type in the message. Because I used to say to you,
"Oh yes, what I just told you is true. I'll show you the messages."
Well, I crafted those messages with her. So if you would see them, it would substantiate my fake story. We help each other out, she and I. We're birds of a feather. We lie for each other. We cover up for each other. So yes, you were right. When you suspected that was what was going on.
And it is.
Well,
hip hip hooray for you!